In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone. Today we celebrate the feast of St. Henry. St. Henry died around the year 1024 in the Germanies. There was no such place as Germany, per se, at the time. He was the second of that name, the Holy Roman Emperor. He and his wife, St. Cunegunda, were known for being great people who worked with the poor. He founded monasteries. He brought forth the faith in the Germanies during that time. And we celebrate him today as a leader and as someone who stood up for the faith throughout difficult times. As is our custom, as we prepare to have been transformed by these sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Intercede for us. Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us. Forgive us our sins. And bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, whose abundant grace prepared St. Henry to be raised by you in a wonderful way from the cares of earthly rule to heavenly realms, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that amid the uncertainties of this world, we may hasten towards you with minds made pure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Reading from the book of the prophet Micah. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow before God most high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with 1,000 rams, with a myriad streams of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my crop, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? You have been told, O man, what is good. What the Lord requires of you, only do the right, and to love goodness, and to walk humbly with your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, God. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the ways of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord, and meditates on his law day and night. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. He is like a tree planted near running water, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does, prospers. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes. Blessed are they who hope in the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Whoever loves me will keep my word. My Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says the Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who knows the will of my Father in heaven. Many will say on that day, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? Did we not drive out demons in your name? Did we not do mighty deeds in your name?' Then I will declare to them solemnly, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, evildoers.' Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and buffeted the house, but it did not collapse, for it had been set solidly on rock." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
This gospel reading is perhaps My favorite, you know I say it all the time, but my favorite gospel passage for weddings. You probably know that as director of the Office of Family Ministries for the Archbishop, I'm in charge of all marriage preparation for everybody in the diocese. I work with the parishes and with the deacons and priests and all those lay leaders and the couples themselves. I manage the Foundation for Marriage program for the diocese. We have about 400 couples that I'll work with personally every year that go through that program as they're preparing for marriage. And that's just one side of what I do as the deacon here in St. Gabriel. Naturally, I'm in charge of marriage preparation here because that's what I do for the diocese. I like to say this is kind of my living laboratory where I get to do the work that I'm talking about all the time there. So all the weddings that happen here, most of them I do actually, but those I don't, I work with. And this is the reading that I recommend. Now, there's lots they can choose, but I recommend this one above all others because I think it so clearly says what marriage is supposed to be. It is really about the Christian life and what it is supposed to be. It's being big enough to recognize that God is bigger than you. It's that ultimate act of selflessness where you put your faith in something that lasts. Christ is very clear in this message. You can say all you want to, and you can even do good deeds, but ultimately, you have to do what he says and follow him throughout your life. It was always confusing to me while they say they do all these great things and Jesus rebukes them and says he doesn't know it. Well, the key to that is the part of it, depart from me, you evildoers. Publicly, there are many people that live the life of the righteous, but it is not in their hearts. That's what Jesus is talking about here. Privately, they may do all sorts of evil things. Christ knows our hearts. He knows our ways. He knows our failings and our weaknesses. He does not condemn us for those, but he does condemn us if that's what we worship, if that's what we live for. If we say one thing and do something different, that something different better be what Jesus Christ says. That's what he's saying here. Now, this is Matthew's Gospel. This is chapter 7, the very end, actually, of the Sermon on the Mount. 18 chapters later, we hear the story of the sheep and the goats. That's kind of the fulfillment of this passage. They're meant to be linked together. Now, that's Matthew. There's lots of pieces. He's got an intricate gospel, so many things fit with each other. But these two are pretty tight to each other. It's intended to remind us that when Jesus comes, he will come as the just judge. And that does sound a little scary. And there are those who say, wait a minute, is Jesus like that? Well, he said so. But to reduce him down to just that would be a disservice because he says so many other things. The beauty of Jesus Christ and the beauty of the gospel, the beauty of all that he taught us, it is an infinitely faceted gem. If we try and simplify things, talk about only this or only that, we miss the point. That is exactly the problem. In fact, that's the human way for so many people. The complexity is where we lose it. We can't think beyond something one thing at a time. That's why we have the liturgical cycle. We will come week after week, day after day, and talk about a different facet of Jesus Christ, hoping over time we get them all. Because God is both all just and all merciful. And that does seem to be at odds with each other, but that's because we are human and we are limited. He is not. He is able to do both perfectly. This reading, as well as the one we hear with the sheep and the goats, are two examples of the just Jesus. We hear plenty of examples of the merciful Jesus as well, and we'll explore those as we go on. The reason for this reading is that today, St. Henry was known to be the follower of Jesus Christ, who put aside the world, who ruled justly and properly. He did not accept himself and his duties, but Jesus Christ was his law. Jesus Christ was his God. That's who he followed. That's what gave him his sanctity. And that's what's available to each and every one of us, day in and day out. We may not be as famous as St. Henry or many other saints that are known, but to me that doesn't matter, nor should it to you. All that matters is that eternal crown. Build our house upon it. this community of faith. May God provide us courage and strength as we carry our own crosses. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died, may the mercy and love of God enfold them and bring them to eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, you ask great things of us as we strive to follow the way of the cross. Hear the prayers we offer you today. We ask you this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. Stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power,
and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And with whatever way we are comfortable, please offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God. Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world,
grant
us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, or my soul shall be healed. And the body of Christ can be saved for eternal life.
May the sacrament we are about to receive, O Lord, in the commemoration of Blessed St. Henry, sanctify our minds and hearts, that we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature. Through Christ,